Hey twins, how's it going? It's Ashley from Serendipity Twins Tarot, and this is your general love reading for my twin flames, right? We're gonna see what's going on with you guys in your twin flame journey, on the journey. We're gonna see what's happening, okay? So I have some tarot and oracle cards, and we're gonna just get your messages, okay? So I'm being called to start off today with the unspoken love messages. Okay, I want to see what your person has to say right now. What are some things that they have a difficult time telling you, but it's on their mind, it's on your chest. Okay, some words that perhaps they really want to say from their higher self, but they don't have the means to say it. They're afraid. They may be holding back, cat at their tongue, right? So messages for the twin flames, messages from their twin. What's going on? Allow me to work on me so I can work on us. So this is someone here who's working on themselves, being a better person, being able to be real with you, right? This is someone who could have ran away because they weren't ready to be real. They weren't ready to experience real love, right? And I feel like they could have caused you immense pain because they may have abandoned something that was real, that was genuine, where there was a lot of love between you guys. So right now, your person is saying, allow me, like, give me the permission to work on myself because right now, I can't be that person for you. I need to fix myself before I can fix this connection. My pride and ego led us astray. So yeah, I feel like your person's pride and ego was the reason why your person may have not been able to surrender. I feel like this could have caused divisions in this connection, their pride. All right, they're too prideful to admit their wrongs, right? You accepted me for me, the good, the bad, the ugly. I couldn't do the same. So this is someone here who, like, you weren't perfect, they weren't perfect. But the difference was that you didn't try to be perfect. You just tried to be yourself. You were real with this person, and this person could not be that person, right? They couldn't be real. They couldn't be honest, be truthful. And there were some things that, yeah, they needed to work on, but they acted as if, oh, I'm good all by myself. You know, I don't need to work on myself. And now they're realizing that, yeah, I need to work on myself. There are things that I don't like about myself, and I gotta change it. So it's like this person definitely did not admit their wrongs, and they could have, you could have accepted them for their weaknesses and their imperfections, and they just couldn't do the same for you, right? So we have hurting you was not the plan. So this person, again, caused a lot of hurt, emotional pain, maybe even betrayed you, but that wasn't what they wanted to do. That was not what their heart was set on doing. They did not, it's like you just happened to be in the way of them just trying to figure out what the heck they wanted, right? Unfortunately, you were in the middle of it, and therefore you're the one who got hurt the most. But that wasn't what they really wanted. Hurting you, yeah, hurt me even more. So hurting you again wasn't the plan. They got hurt as well because they didn't like to see you hurt. A lot of you guys, it brought tears to your eyes. You know, you were so hurt that you became very vengeful or angry, upset with them, and they didn't like seeing you hurt. There is no good reason for the way I acted. I wish I could apologize. So if they have not apologized yet, you guys, this is confirming that they wish they could apologize. There's no reason why they did what they did, right? They're at fault. There's no good excuse. Even if they tried to make excuses for what they did, this is saying, I wish I could tell you how sorry I am. I really want your forgiveness. I was so wrong on so many different levels. I'm scared you will not accept me now. So a lot of you guys, there could be energy of wanting to come back in, wanting to be in your life, wanting to have movement change, maybe even communicate with you. But what's holding them back is their fear of rejection, fear that they'll never be that person you need them to be, fear that they're going to fail. And so they may also feel that you won't allow them back into your life, right? A lot of you guys, whatever they did to you, it's like, how in the hell are you going to allow them to come back in and move forward and rebuild this connection? I'm so embarrassed. I acted foolish and don't know how to tell you how sorry I am. Again, very, very sorry, very apologetic. So let's get some more messages and see what is going on. Messages for the twins on their journeys with their twin flame. What do we need to know? Clear messages. Finding sanctuary, opening up to your spiritual source. So a lot of you guys, you may be spending a lot of time by yourself. Finding sanctuary is like finding self, right? Going within, reflecting, introspection. It's kind of like the hermit energy in tarot. Some of you guys are dealing with a Virgo. That sanctuary energy is like finding your sacred place and just like sitting in it for a little bit, really connecting with yourself, strengthening your intuition. A lot of you guys, you're connecting yourself with spirit, with source, right? You've never been so spiritual until you went through this journey. And so this could be an opportunity where doors are opening and it's allowing you to connect with your spiritual realm on a higher level than you ever did. So a lot of you guys, during this time, you're reaching out to spirit to guide you down this journey. Valiant courage. Valiant courage. Take action with passion. So right now it's like your person wants to take action, right? They're coming up with the courage, the willpower, the drive to move forward. But the thing is that they have to come in and be confident. Know that, you know what? It's going to be a victoria. I'm going to win this. I got it. And that is something that they're not there yet. So I really feel like it is the energy pushing your person forward to come to right things in this connection, right their wrongs with you. But it's going to require them to have no fear. It's going to require them to put aside their pride and ego, right? It's going to require them to take action and really know that, you know what? I can do this with confidence, with reassurance, with conviction, right? So that could be creating delays right now. We have the mystic healer energy. Healing energy flows through you. So a lot of you guys know that during this time of separation, you may feel like, oh, nothing's happening. Things are stuck and stagnant. Haven't heard from my person. There's no communication. But what's going on is right now is that you're healing. Your body is going through intense healing. You're recovering. You're purging. You're letting go of what doesn't serve you. You're allowing for new opportunities to come in. So mystic healer, some of you guys, you are healers. You're light workers, right? You're star seeds. There's healing energy around you. And a lot of you guys, you're now accepting yourself to this healing works, right? Maybe before you weren't ready to heal. You weren't ready to acknowledge that you had insecurities. You had issues with self-love. And so now there's healing energy coming to you, but it's happening at this time where you guys are separated, right? Vast vistas, expand your horizons, okay? So I feel like there's really about something here about opening doors. Doors opening up, new opportunities. I really feel like a lot of you guys, you're learning about who you are, okay? Your spirituality. It could be about learning what you're passionate about, going towards something that you're passionate about, exploring your gifts, you know, your skills, and really manifesting greatness, abundance into your life. I also feel like this is happening for your person on a different level. They're learning about themselves, but they're not seeing things the way they saw it before, right? This is someone who could have had tunnel vision. They were so in their own little world. They didn't see above that. They didn't see this vision of being with you, living a harmonious, happy life, family, right? Commitment. And now something is becoming bigger, right? They're seeing that life is so much bigger than just them and what they saw. They're now seeing something more clearly. There's doors opening up here, okay? Begin now, voyage of the heart, and we have embracing enthusiasm. Okay, so begin now. It's just take the first step. So right now your person is being challenged, being pushed by universe to take that first step, right? Move forward, up, start this journey, come towards you, reach out, break silence, right? So your person is wanting a beginning, a new beginning, and they know that in order to have this new beginning, it's going to be challenging, right? Because this kind of looks like the Ten of Wands in tarot. There's like a big hill and valley before them carrying a big, you know, a lot of on their back burdens. But it says take the first step. So in order to accomplish something, in order to move forward, they have to be that first person to take that step. So your person is working on being the bigger person moving forward. Maybe coming up with a plan or strategy on how to come towards you. We have the voyage of the heart. So this speaks about love flowing through you and to you. So now there's a heart matter here, right? And so we talked about healing, mystic healer. And so right now, you guys may be healing your heart chakra. There's a lot of healing around the heart energy. But it's now, you know, your person's energy. They were not ready for love, right? They were not ready for love. Their heart was cold, was hard, was rock solid, however you want to describe it, right? Broken. They weren't ready to love. They were damaged. And so what it's telling me is that now they're healing their heart, and that's allowing them to accept love, to give love, to receive love, right? And so your person couldn't do all these things before. And so when you had your heart open and vulnerable, being real with them and giving them, you know, your love, giving them attention, they weren't ready to receive it, right? And it only pushed them further along, further away, down a different path. And so now there's a voyage of the heart, right? Now your person's on a journey, voyage of learning about their heart, learning about their feelings, being ready to accept these feelings and not run away from it because they're afraid, right? So embracing enthusiasm, it says, shout out to the heavens with happiness. So there's something, there's a passionate new beginning. There's excitement. Page of Wands is like that energy of the enthusiasm. There's the energy of wanting to communicate, shout, right? Shout out, reach out, communicate something here. I feel like your person really wants to talk to you, but they're having a really difficult time. All right, so let's see what else we could find out. Messages for my twins. Just a reminder, these two Oracle cards decks is available on my Etsy shop. This is the Soulmates Unspoken Love Messages and the Divine Love Oracle, okay? You can find these on my Etsy shop, and they're available for immediate shipment. All right, we have observation. Carefully observe the situation to come up with an accurate assessment. So I feel like your person is in the energy of observing, trying to figure out, what do I do? A lot of you guys, they could be observing you. They could be watching you from a distance, trying to find out what's going on. Are you still mad at me? Are you still upset? You know, are you still hurt? Are you still thinking about me? So they're observing the situation. They're trying to find out what's next, what they can do, how they can come in, strategizing, right? Negligent acts stem from past abandonment. So a lot of you guys, you need to know this. The reason why your person neglected this connection was not because they didn't care for you, but because they've gone through some kind of past abandonment. They've been abandoned by someone in the past. It could have been a past relationship. Could have been someone who left them at the altar, right? All of a sudden, broken engagement. Could have been a parent that left them when they were a child. There's some kind of abandonment that your person has faced in their love life or in their life in general, right? Just keep this really open. And that abandonment has led to some issues in their love life, in their relationships, not being able to carry things through or complete a mission, right? They neglected, they abandoned it, they can kind of go missing. Karmic cycle. Someone has to learn an invaluable life lesson to set their soul free. So some of you guys, your person has some karma they had to pay off, and that could be why this connection was sabotaged. There was karma here. There's some karmic ties. There's some karmic debt, right? So I feel like your person is learning that if they keep avoiding responsibility, if they keep saying, you know what, I'm not ready to learn this lesson, right? They keep repeating the cycles over and over and over, and that's what this energy is about. This is someone who wants to set their soul free, but they're not going to set their soul free if they continue to avoid responsibility and not learn their lesson. So they have to learn a lesson first in order for them to live a life that's not restricted, a life that is that's free, that's fulfilling, that's loving, right? All right, we have affection and we have sorrow. An open display of love and special attention to each other's needs is warranted. So I feel like your person had issues in showing love, issues in opening up the heart chakra, right? Telling you, it could have been like a affirmation. It could have been telling you how much they care about you. Admitting their love, right? Saying, I love you. Those words could have scared the hell out of this person. They never said it. So I also feel like there could have been some deception. They showed you affection, but they didn't really mean it, or it didn't really come from the heart space, okay? Some issues regarding showing and displaying of love. We also have sorrow. This is like the Five of Cups energy. Sadness, regrets dwells in someone's heart. So your person is regretting a lot of things they may have said, things they could have done, thinking of the past, thinking of memories and what they could have done to hurt you. I feel like this is someone here who did not realize how hurtful their words were. They may have said some mean, awful things, and they're like, oh my gosh, I can't believe I said that. Those words came out of my mouth. And it could be haunting them now. There's a lot of sorrow, feeling like, I can't believe I did that. Ego, we just talked about pride and ego. So ego certainly may have been causing a misdirection or someone to block this connection, right? Their ego, they were so caught up with themselves. We have roadblocks here as well. blocks have to be removed in order for this to move forward. So the blockages here is this person, right? Blockage in their heart chakra. It could be a blockage regarding fear, commitment issues, right? That is creating a blockage. Selfishness, pride, ego, these are all blockages, right? And so it also could be past abandonment, blockages. These blocks, in order for your person to really move forward and have a loving relationship with you, they have to work on these blockages one at a time, lesson by lesson, until they learn their lesson and they're able to move forward and be fulfilling. Deep thinking, take time to reflect and consider all options and consequences. So right now there's a lot of deep thinking going on, right? We have that finding sanctuary energy, connecting with your spiritual source, going within, reflecting, thinking of what I can do, how I can do better, how can I achieve this, right? So that is what I'm seeing. Let's get some tarot up in here and yeah, get you some more messages. All right, come on, spirit. Any more messages that we have for the twin flames out here? All right, allow me to work on me so I can work on us. What is this about? What is this person trying to work on us? What is this about? We have the Queen of Swords in reverse with the Two of Swords. So I think that, you know, your twin is in the energy of not being honest, not being truthful. I feel like there really was something going on within them, right? They were not complete. They were not whole. They could have came from a place that was very dysfunctional, and they were damaged. And so they were at a crossroads, right? They didn't know what they wanted. They feared love. They couldn't move forward because they were stuck. Two of Swords. So there's something about this person having to work on themselves. Some of you guys, they had to work on something regarding a maternal figure. Queen of Swords could have been also wanting to do the work because they know that if they didn't, they would hurt you. And unfortunately, they end up hurting you anyway, right? So let's see. I'm scared you will not accept me now. What is this about? The Empress in reverse and the Ace of Pentacles. So what your person wants to offer is a new beginning, something very promising, stable, grounded, something long term. So they may want to offer a commitment, but the problem is that they're afraid that the Empress, the divine feminine, won't look at them the same, right? A lot of you guys, you are that divine feminine, and they're afraid that they hurt you so bad, they, you know, really betrayed you, you know, they really turned you out to the point where you may not look at them the same. You know, you may not take this offer, you may reject them. And so they could be afraid. They could be afraid to come towards you to offer something like this after them hurting you, because you're coming out in reverse. So it's almost like you've given up on them. At least they feel that way. There is no good reason for the way I acted. I wish I can apologize. What's this about? The Nine of Cups and the Nine of Wands in reverse. So they're sorry that they were very selfish. The Nine of Cups is overindulgent, only thinking about themselves. And the truth is that you made them happy. You fulfilled their needs. You fulfilled their cup up. And the Nine of Wands in reverse is that they just kind of gave up. When things were tough, when things got difficult, when there was like one argument, they kind of just said, oh, I'm done. I don't want to do this anymore. And so that's the energy. There's no good reason for the way they acted, right? And they never got a chance to apologize to you. So hurting you was not the plan. Why is this here? Yeah, the Hermit and the Chariot. They never told you this, but the Hermit is kind of like them going within and spending a lot of time with themselves and realizing how much they hurt you. And I don't think they realize how hurtful their actions were, their behaviors were, their words were, until they actually take time to really think about it. The Chariot is that, you know, it wasn't their plan and they do want to move forward with you. They want some kind of change and victory over a situation. What is this? Take action with passion, valiant courage. It may require them to be courageous to take action towards you. Yeah, and get out of their head. Nine of Swords in reverse with the Page of Swords in reverse. So a lot of you guys, the reason why they haven't come in and taken action towards you is because there's stress, anxiety, worries in their head about this. How am I ever going to make up for something I've done? And the Page of Swords in reverse is saying that your person's afraid to communicate. They don't know what to say. They don't know how to break the silence, how to initiate communication. It can be really difficult for them. And so a lot of you guys, they're kind of watching you and waiting for that right time, waiting for the right moment to come in and initiate some kind of movement. Okay, so valiant courage is they do want to take action, but they may not know how to. So let's find out more about this voyage of the heart. Love flows through you and to you. Wow, Page of Cups and the King of Pentacles. Now this is someone who realizes that, yeah, I can have all these materialistic things. I can have other people in my life. I can have more money and expensive car and great job, but I am no one or I am nothing without love. And so this is someone who's now healing their heart and realizing that what they want more than anything outside of riches and gold is love, true love. And so the Page of Cups is here. This is someone who's learning how to love, learning how to offer their cup and be genuine and true. And so this is also the energy of someone wanting to apologize. I'm sorry I wasn't there for you. I'm sorry I could have been there for you, right? You expected a lot from me with the King of Pentacles, but I let you down, right? I disappointed you big time. And so there's an energy of learning how to love now, right? So let's see what else we can find out with this sorrow energy, observing you, sorrow. What's this about? Three of Swords in reverse with the Knight of Pentacles in reverse. This person is sorry that they did not take the right action towards you. We have the Knight of Pentacles in reverse. This is someone who may have promised you a commitment but never actually came in to deliver it. They may have made promises that they didn't keep. This is someone who was not moving at all, not giving you stability, not making you feel secure in the connection. And so with the Three of Swords, it's like, yeah, they hurt you, but they also hurt themselves. Hurting you hurt me even more. So this is someone who's equally hurt by what they've done and the fact that they betrayed you. They sabotaged a relationship here. So that is what I'm seeing. I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. Like, share, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you know when I upload these readings. And I wish you all the best. Take care.